a lot of people discovered chic, and because you know, we were looking for something that was really great but was not old-fashioned.
Yeah.
And so disco was a big part of my generation, because it was feminine, it was uplifting, and it was great pop, and it was just thrown out. So I'll tell you the story, and I know.
But
me and my friends were about 1978, and I'm just devouring all sorts of music, all sorts of guitar music, and my friend, you know, a bunch of us were, including Andy Rocky, was my best friend at the time, and this world really into Neil Young, you know. So,
Scorpio.
Neil Young's a Scorpio.
Ah,
right. And, nice. I didn't know that. So, that makes sense. But, I tell this story in the book, but it was a big influence on me. Like, coming out of that post, trying to find choices, trying to find a direction. So when my parents used to go out on Friday night, and usually on Saturday too, and when they went out, we used to watch the taillights of my parents' car go out into the distance, and then all these kids, I grew up on that housing estate, huge housing estate in Manchester, the projects are called in, right? So it was the biggest housing estate in Europe. And as soon as my parents' car disappeared, all these kids were just piling at my house, right? And my sister, who was 11 months younger than me, who I was very tight with, she really loved disco music. Me and my friends were in my bedroom listening to Neil Young. So my parents were out, and we've got that tiny little bit of hash, and got the red light bulb in, and we're all sitting around. And,
old man sitting by the side of the road.
Sitting there like, digging in. And my sister's in her room.
I want you, don't let it bring you down.
This is a true story. One night, my sister just opened the door. She looked in and she just said, "You guys look like you're having a good time."
That's enough, right?
So I went into a room next door, and I heard this amazing music. Niall, if you fuck this up, I'm sorry, man, but I heard this guitar that just was like a... I got really hooked on Mal Rogers, and I still had this kind of my own kind of style going that came from who knows where. And then when you know the Smiths formed and all of this stuff, it's a whole other story. I'm sure you want to hear about it. But I want to tell this. I went back to my parents' house one day, and Smiths had about six songs, and I was sitting around. I went to visit him one Sunday afternoon, and I started to play this riff that was going. It was going on. So I thought, great, we'll turn us into a disco band. But I didn't have a tape recorder, I didn't have anything recorded. I thought, this is a happy riff, you know, this is really good. So I was like, shit, I've got nothing to record it on, you know. I was like, Twelve. So Angie, my girlfriend at the time, she had her parents' little VW Beetle, and I said to her, like, right, okay, I'm going to have to drive around to Morris's because he's got a tape recorder. So I've got this little guitar, I'm sat with my feet up on the dashboard, and she's driving, and I've just got... trying not to get it ready. And so then when I got to Morris's house 20 minutes later, and I was praying it wasn't the one day of the year where he would leave the house. But just before I got there, I'm playing that riff, and Angie, who very rarely, in the 30-odd years we've been together, very rarely interjects on anything when I'm writing. But she just, before I just got to Morrissey, she said, make it sound like Iggy. And I was carrying on playing, sounding like Nile Rodgers as much as I could, and she said, make it sound like Iggy. So I just played it like a... So I got to the door and Morrissey opened, and I was sort of stood there serenading him. he ran off and got the tape recorder and recorded it, and then that became our first single. And where you sort of, you know, you start off with that kind of disco inspiration from Nile, one of the first things that I could play when I was a kid was, because I just started off as a little glam rocker in the 70s, was Rebel Rebel, you know. So somewhere when in that Hand in Glove riff, I put in it. So that's how the first Smith single came along. It was to do with like Rebel Rebel crossed with Chic, and it